about today is the concept of perfection. That I am never gonna be perfect because I'm human, but that is my strength. Because when you stop chasing physical perfection, and I'm talking about all those articles that we read in the magazine and all the girls that we compare ourselves to, there's always gonna be somebody prettier than you, there's always gonna be someone skinnier than you, there's always gonna be someone that's better physically than you, but only you are you, and you're never going to be perfect, and that is so empowering. Because when you stop chasing this never-ending race towards physical perfection, you can start focusing on your passions, expanding your mind, creating connections with girls that aren't out of jealousy, that aren't out of competition, because that is really hard to find. Sit with yourself and give yourself some kindness, some compassion, some love. If you're going through hard stuff, just know you're a human, man. You're a human and we have feelings and they're scary, but they're so valid and you just need to feel them, you know? Don't run away from them, don't judge them, don't call names, don't be like, I'm so fucked up. Like, we're all fucked up, but we're beautiful, you know? So follow your passions in life, hug people, compliment people, and if you're having a rough day, have a rough day. Drive to the beach, drink on coconut, and just smile, you know? Like, look at this beautiful world we live in, you know? It's just like, we don't do this enough. We don't take a moment for ourselves and really sit with our feelings and be in the present moment and just take a deep breath and realize we are alive and having a human experience that gets hard sometimes. But when you really put your head down and you make a true path for yourself, you can go so far. Like, that's what we should be told as kids.
Like, there is magic in real life. Anything is possible when you manifest it, when you really back yourself, when you give yourself enough time to love yourself and love the skin you're in and love the mind that you have. If you really set your mind to something, you can do it. Saying in my head, acceptance, 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 because that is the one thing that has like actually helped me. Accepting my feelings and my like down moments as much as accepting my high moments. What I spoke about was, I love myself enough to know what I deserve. I love myself enough to know what I want in life. I love myself enough to know where I should restrain myself from the stuff that I don't need or the people that I shouldn't be surrounding myself with. And I spoke about how society puts barriers on us to stop us from loving ourselves and doing what we love. And today I want to talk about how we can break down this. And the last thing I want to talk about is the word now. I got a tattoo saying now because it is my word. Just like Issa's word is purpose, mine is now. What I learned from this book that I was reading was like the most mind-blowing thing that we should just get taught the minute we're born is that the past is not real anymore. It's actually gone. You know, you can never get the past back, and we know this. The future isn't even happening yet. So why do we focus on that when we literally live our lives not even in this moment right now? We are constantly depressed about the past and we're anxious about the future. This is how anxiety forms. We literally are tormenting ourselves as humans. The minute I started and stopped and I was like, all I have is this moment right now, it has been the one thing that has pulled me out of any anxious feeling.
Don't just say okay to whatever society tells you is the norm, is the acceptable. Question everything. Choose to do what you love to do, not what society, your peers, or your parents want you to do. Things always have a way of working out. So focus on that. Be inspired by that. The universe has a funny way of unfolding things. Just honestly, learn to go with it. Know that whatever you may be facing now, it will work out. And in a year or two, those bad feelings, they won't matter. So don't give them too much attention in the now either. Focus on the solutions. You deserve the best. And once you start believing that, everyone else will too.